Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have studied about the processes and their types. So now we are going to do a deep analysis, that is what is actually reversible and what is irreversible process. So let us talk about it. So we are going to discuss about what is a reversible process and what is irreversible process. So talking about the first one, that is for reversible process. So let us know the definition of it, that what does it means. So reversible process means any process conducted in such a manner that at every stage driving force is infinitesimally greater than the opposing force and which can be reversed by slightly increase in the opposing force. This means what? This is basically similar to that of the thermodynamic equilibrium. For instance, if I give you an example of like mechanical equilibrium, then in this case the driving force and the opposing force, this will make both of them to cancel out each other, or they will have a balance between them. So if they are being balanced, that means the value or the force, the driving force and the opposing force are almost equal. And suppose if in this case, if I make a slight increase in the opposing force, then what will happen? So suppose if I increase the slight force in opposing force, then my overall process will be a reverse process, because in this case initially what happens is the driving force and the opposing force, the both are equal. Now increasing a slight force among the driving force or to the opposing force, it would change the reaction, or it would change the process, or it would reverse the process. So such kind of process in which they are basically delicate, they are delicate in the form of the driving force and for the opposing force, for both. So we could reverse the process. Suppose if A plus B gives us C plus D, and in that case suppose the driving force is converting A plus B to C plus D, and the opposing force, it is almost equal to that of driving force like A and B. But what happens is the opposing force is slightly smaller, that is infinitesimally smaller than that of the driving force. So in that case, suppose if I increase a slight force or slight energy for the opposing force, then what will happen is the opposing force now will be slightly greater than that of the driving force. And now what I'll get is C plus D will give us A plus B, which is a reverse reaction. So this is basically was a short synopsis that what does the reversible process means. So let us now understand the what are the features that are for the irreversible process, or what are the things that we could find in a reversible process. So these are the features of a reversible process in which the following are being observed or the following are being maintained. So the driving force and opposing force differ from each other infinitesimally. The first thing is, this is the most biggest criteria that when we are talking about a reversible process, it is that the driving force and opposing force will have a difference, but very very minute difference, or very very small difference, known as infinitesimally difference. So this is the main thing between when we are talking about a reversible process. So now the next one is, it can be reversed at any point changing the condition. It is true, because there are two kind of forces, that is driving forces and opposing forces, which are being balanced or which are almost equal but having a small difference. Suppose if I have to maintain the reaction to be a forward reaction, or if I want to make the process to be in a forward process, so what I am going to do, I'll increase the force, a kind of force which would be increasing the driving force, and that would lead to a forward reaction or a forward process. So that kind of energy or that small amount of force I could apply for the opposing force also. So if I applied a small force to the opposing force, then what will happen? A reversible process is being observed. So in this case, I could change the process just by changing the condition. So the overall process can be reversed, and hence this kind of processes are known as reversible process, because this process can be reversed at any time, at any point, by just changing the conditions. So now the next one is, The process takes place in an infinite number of steps. Yes, it takes place at infinite number of steps, because the in this process, as we know, that because the driving force and opposing force are almost equal to each other, so what will happen, they for maintaining a particular process or to give a particular transformation from one form to another form, they would take infinite time, as well as they could take infinite steps, so as to convert from one form to another form. So this is the main thing that they have made mentioned, is that they takes infinite number of steps for following a process. So now talking about the next one. Yes, this one, it indicates that the system attains mechanical equilibrium at the end of every step of process. It clearly indicates, same as I would consider the same example, like a gas which is been enclosed in a cylinder with a frictionless piston. So suppose if the gas has been expanding, and the gas is expanding very slowly, so what happens is, if it expands rapidly, and what we could observe is, we could observe the changes that is in the parameters, like or the state functions, like pressure, volume and temperature, which was P1, T1, and suddenly it has changed to P2, V2 and T2. But in the reversible process, what happens is, there will be change, but the change will be very infinitesimal, that is, it will be very much small. So overall in this process, the state functions are not being changed that much. So that's the reason they have said that the mechanical equilibrium is being maintained in that process. So the driving force and opposing force, because the both are almost same, so in that case the mechanical force is also being maintained, or the mechanical equilibrium is also being maintained throughout the whole reversible process and at every stage of that reaction or of that process. So what happens because of this, actually because of this, it results in maximum work. Maximum work is obtained because no more heat or no more kind of energy is being wasted, because it is been taking place in a very slow step. And the last one is, the process takes place slowly. Yes, that is what I was talking about. The process takes place slowly, that the system is always temperature and pressure equilibrium with the surrounding. So this is the thing that when we have to maintain a reversible process, these are the features in the reversible process. And the most important thing is, yes, the driving force and opposing force that we have discussed, and yes, and the most important thing is the maximum work that we obtain from a reversible process. So this was the thing about reversible process. So now let us talk about what is actually a reversible process. So let us talk about irreversible process. It means the process conducted in such a manner that the driving force is greater than the opposing force, and even small increase in the opposing force is unable to reverse the process. That kind of process are known as irreversible process. It is quite very different from that of the irreversible process, because we know that in reversible process, that is the driving force and opposing force, they were almost equal with a slight amount, with a slight energy, with a slight difference. But when we are talking about irreversible process, so there is a huge difference, or there is a more difference between the driving force and opposing force. And even though if we give slight amount of energy or slight amount of force to the opposing force, then this won't reverse the overall process. So that is the difference between the two, that is the irreversible and the reversible process. So this was the statement which was clearly indicating that this process are not being reversed at any step. So now talking about the features, similarly that we have discussed the features of reversible process, now we are going to discuss the features of the irreversible process. The first difference, yes, it is a major difference that we can observe for a reversible and irreversible process, that is more difference is between the driving force and opposing force. That is the first feature that we are observing. The second, it cannot be reversed at any point, because according to the definition also, we have got to know that yes, it cannot be reversed at any point. Even though if we increase a slight amount of force for the opposing force, or slight force if we increase in the opposing force, we cannot change the overall process. And it's the process takes place in a finite number of steps, because it is being taken in finite number of steps, and that's the reason the work that has been obtained, it is not like that of the maximum work. So that is what we have talking about. Yes, the work obtained is not maximum, but yes, work will be obtained, but it won't be like maximum in a reversible process. And the last one is equilibrium, that is exists, equilibrium only exists in the initial stage and final stage. So this point indicates what? Because we have studied what is thermodynamic equilibrium, and in this case we have also studied that the state function are won't change, and because of that what happens is the thermodynamic equilibrium is being maintained. So when we are talking about a reversible process, so what happens is the change takes place very minute. So what happens is still the mechanical equilibrium is being maintained in that process, that is the thermodynamic equilibrium. But when we are talking about a irreversible process, so what happens is the change takes place rapidly, or we could say is that the change that takes place, it is a major change that we observe, and that's the reason we cannot find equilibrium. Yes, the equilibrium will be maintained, or we will observe if the equilibrium is being maintained at the initial stage, because at that point the pressure, volume and temperature, or all the state function that we know, it would be maintained in a constant way, and within the reaction it won't be the same, it would change, that pressure, volume, they will change. And after the process has been completed, that when it is at the final stage, at that point the equilibrium we could observe, that is the thermodynamic equilibrium. So the difference between the reversible process and irreversible process is, in reversible process equilibrium is maintained at every end of the infinite steps, but in this case it takes place but from initial stage and to the final stage, that is when we are talking about irreversible process. So these are the two differences and the two major features that we have observed, that what is in reversible and what is in irreversible process. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video and you will share this video with your friends and try to know more about this thing. And yes, and don't forget to subscribe to Ikeda channel. Thank you so much.